signs of trouble or anything. Strange. Well, let's see if anyone's alive here. Sir? Sorry, sir. Hello? Showing you how to make a vampire from the awesome TV series about vampires taking over, actually better said, Dracula taking over New York, if I'm not mistaken, in the 21st century. It's a really good story with a really good twist. It's called The Strain, and this is how the vampires look when people are fully infected. When you get infected, you kind of go through three phases. First you're human, you gotta get a cold, then you start losing a little bit of your hair, then you lose a little bit more of your hair, and you kind of start getting, like your veins start protruding. And then in the end you look like this. This is of course me as a vampire eating. But if you want to do the bald cap version, then I do recommend finding another YouTube tutorial on how to apply bald caps, because I applied the bald cap at the end of the video, and this is why it's a little bit rough and it's not really perfect, just because I wanted to show you how this look would look with your actual natural hair, so if you just want to do the face, and how it would look if you would apply a bald cap. So this was just an example of the bald cap. There are many very good tutorials on YouTube about applying bald caps. I really don't need to do it. And yeah, that's that. So hopefully you guys like this video, and if you do, don't forget to like this video, subscribe, leave a comment below, share this video, and tell me, are you watching The Strain? If not, are you a fan of horror TV series like The Walking Dead? Have you maybe started watching The Z Nation? This is The Strain. There's so many like good horror TV series out there. Leave a comment below, tell me what you're currently watching, and if you would like me to recreate anything. And now let's get down to the tutorial. All right, everyone, today I'm going to be showing you how to make natural looking veins without using alcohol activated makeup. Alcohol activated makeup is expensive, and I'm sure that certain that you're not going to be using it other than for Halloween. So if it is within your budget, you can buy it, you can use it, and there's a whole other method. You don't need to do half of these steps. But if it's not within your budget, then this is a really good, cheap, budget friendly way of making veins which look natural. So we're first going to be taking a green or turquoise pencil and outline the veins on your face noticeably. Don't be afraid to go heavily on this, just because we're going to be applying foundation after. Also, make sure to use a purple reddish hue lip liner or eyeliner and fill out some of the green veins, just so you got kind of get like a purple red hue to some of the veins. It'll look very natural. When you're done with that, don't forget to set these liners with a setting powder, a thin layer, and then apply liquid foundation over it.
When you're done with that, it's time to apply foundation. Make sure that you're using a foundation which is light coverage, not medium, not heavy. It must be light coverage. And take a stipple brush and apply it with a light hand. So you basically want to have a very thin layer of foundation just so you don't overcover the blue pencil which you just drew to imitate the vein. And make sure to go as light as possible, preferably ashy white, but not fully white. So it looks like skin color, but it doesn't look like clown white. If you think some of the veins are still too protruding, go over that, just over that area with the stipple brush lightly until you get the desired effect. If you've over-covered the veins, then with a very, very, very light hand, accentuate the blue-green veins which you just drew. Now we're going to be focusing on the neck part of the vampire. Make sure that you use a reference picture as I did to do this part so that you can do as best as possible. You're going to be using molding wax, and I'm going to be making ahead of time these 3D parts which are going to make this thing on my neck look more 3D. First, I'm going to be applying spear gum and dabbing it with my finger lightly so it becomes tacky. When it becomes tacky, then I'm going to be applying the wax over that so that they can adhere to each other. Now, after you apply all the parts, make sure that you apply a layer of liquid latex over the wax. And then right away over that, apply a thin layer of tissue, and then right over that, automatically apply a layer of liquid latex. Let this set a little bit, and right before you're done, make sure to apply a little setting powder so that the liquid latex can adhere to something. When all of this dries, what you want to do is you want to take the same foundation which you applied on your neck and apply it on that area. Before you apply the foundation, make sure that you draw on any of the veins which you like around the neck area, going down from the face to the neck, and etc., wherever you want else, so that you can again get the same effect which you did on your face. Now, for the shading part about this 3D, I would think it's like a mouth thing, which is on the vampire's neck, make sure to use a reference picture and to add blood, add where it's shading and so on, just so it looks as similar as possible. I'm going back to the face now to accentuate a little bit more of my natural hollows around my eyes, on my eyes, and the hollows of my face, the hollows of my forehead, just very lightly, just so I look a little bit more sick and like exhausted. final touch is the lips. With the same dark brown ashy eyeshadow, go over it with on your lips. You can also apply, if you have a ashy brown eyebrow pencil or lip liner or eyeliner on your lips, and smudge it and set it with a little transparent powder. You're gonna get the same effect. And when you're done with that, make sure to apply blood around your mouth, going down your neck. And that is that.
Okay, hi everyone. So this is the Strain Vampire with hair down, just in case you don't want to put your hair in a bald cap. As you can see, you could just make it really, really, like, very messy. So I just wanted to show you, if you wanted to do this look for Halloween, how it would look like with hair. And now, if you want to see how it's gonna look with a bald cap, make sure to stay tuned. This is what it looks like with a bald cap. So hopefully you guys like it. I know maybe I didn't glue it on well, because I was kind of like rushing last minute. I was like, you know what, let's do a bald cap. If you guys do like this, don't forget to like this video, subscribe, leave a comment below, tell me what other movie, TV, anything character you would like me to recreate, and don't forget to share this if you really enjoyed it. Bye guys!